Hey, Dr. Kynan here, and I want to share something with you. This will probably be the third time this video has been taken down. And it's really strange because I haven't had any video that's had this kind of reaction. So there must be something to this. And so I would encourage you to listen really closely and maybe tag a friend of yours and share. I've been getting a lot of questions. Been reading a lot of comments and just people giving a lot of their thoughts and opinions on a lot of what's going on. We know this has been one of the most stirring times, I think, for most of us in a long time. And there's so much out there. There's so many things that people are talking about, so many theories, if you will. A lot of people are talking about the New World Order. They're talking about 5G towers, they're talking about mass vaccinations, the globalist agenda. But I want to just take a few moments and share the truth behind what we hear as the New World Order. And I really hope you will listen, and I really hope you'll share it with someone. The truth behind the New World Order. And it's early here. I'm waking up. I was up at 2 in the morning praying, and I was so stirred. I woke up and have been up praying. And so if I look a little sleepy, that's why, okay? So please forgive my sleepy look. But I want to talk about the truth behind the New World Order. And one of the first things you and I need to understand is that the New World Order, as we call it in the Latin, is Novus Ordo Seclorum. The New World Order is not new. There's nothing new about the New World Order. In fact, it's an old world order. It's not a New World Order, it's old world. In other words, from the beginning in Genesis chapter 3, when the serpent realized that God had put a man in the garden and had given him authority and wanted a relationship with man, from the beginning of that moment, the enemy of our soul has been trying to subvert the government of God, subvert God's purpose, subvert God's plan. And man was seduced into eating of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And as a result of that seduction and succumbing to that, he ended up being enslaved to sin. And a new world order was established where instead of God being the person that man looked to, man abdicated his spiritual authority and he gave it to the devil. And the devil became the god of this world. You know, he was never more powerful than God, but in terms of the jurisdiction of the earth, Satan became the god of this world. And so we see it. All throughout scripture. We see it when we look in Genesis, where it talks about the Tower of Babel and how man was trying to establish a system in which man was in control, a secular humanistic system where man is in control. And so it is not far-fetched to understand that there are powers of darkness in this world that are trying to subvert the plan of God or to really enslave people. There's no doubt about it. We've seen it all throughout. We saw it with Nebuchadnezzar. We saw it with Pharaoh in Egypt, who enslaved the Egyptians for over 400 years. We've seen it time after time again, this concept of what we know as a new world order. But what I'm telling you is that it's not new. It's not new, it's old. Furthermore, something that you need to understand is that the Bible says in 1 John chapter 2, it says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. For all that's in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world passes away and the lust thereof, but he that does the will of God shall abide forever. Here's the secret you need to know, and I want you to really catch this. It doesn't matter the devil's agenda. It doesn't matter what Satan's trying to do or who he's trying to use to do it. That's totally non-consequential, because the reality is this: whether there are globalists, whether there are all kinds of people with influence in the earth that are trying to roll out an agenda, one thing we know for sure is that that system, whatever system they try to create, will pass away, and the only system that will last is the kingdom of God. And what you need to do, more than trying to worry yourself over who's the Antichrist and who's the Antichrist's first cousin and all this kind of thing, what you need to invest in is your relationship with God. You need to make sure that you are eternally secured. You need to make sure that you know Jesus. Because when we talk about the book of Revelation, one of the things that we forget is that the book of Revelation is not the revelation of the Antichrist, is not the revelation of the mark of the beast, is not the revelation of 666. The book of Revelation starts with the first chapter of Revelation, really the first two verses, and it says the revelation of Jesus Christ. The book of Revelation is about Jesus. It's not just about the destruction. It's not just about the chaos. And sometimes people get so distracted with the things that are not the main focus in Scripture. The main focus is Jesus. The main focus is what Jesus told his disciples in the book of Luke in the 9th chapter. He says, don't rejoice that demons are subjected to you, but rejoice that your name is written in the Lamb's book of life. I'm sorry, that's Luke chapter 10. You need to make sure that your name's in the book, not just who are the characters in the book. You need to know the main character in the book, who's Jesus. And you need to make sure that your life is engrafted in him, because that is our protection against every demonic system, every demonic technology, every weapon of the enemy that he would use to seek to destroy, to seek to subvert, to seek to attack. This is the key. You need to make sure that you know Jesus, because he also came in to usher in a new world order. He came to usher in a world where all things are gone, and behold, all things are new. 2 Corinthians 5:17, that if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. All things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new. You need to make sure that you are in the kingdom of God, and seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things can be added unto you, will be added unto you. Are you in the kingdom? That's the order you need to be concerned about more than anything else, is the kingdom order of God. Not 5G towers, not all of these things that you have no control over. You have no control over those things. But what you do have control over is your relationship with God. You do have control over your faith in God. You can make sure that your faith and trust are rested in the living Christ, are rested in the Savior, because that is your security in the days ahead. That is your security in the days to come. As we go into more and more perilous times, you need to make sure that your relationship with God is absolutely secured. Not who is the Antichrist's nephew or auntie. You need to make sure, do I know Jesus? Do I know Christ? Some people are more concerned about the Antichrist than Christ. They want to know who the Antichrist is, but they don't know who Christ is. It won't make a difference. It won't make a difference. It won't make a difference if you are outside of the will of God. And so I just want to encourage you with this. Facebook took this down. I mean, they blocked this video a number of times, but I'm telling you, I felt like the word should get out. Please share this with a friend. Remind everybody that Jesus is Lord. They say, well, 5G towers. Yes, do you know, okay, 5G, okay? Do you know 316? You're talking about 5G. Do you know 316? Hallelujah. Do you know the B66? We want to talk about 5G. Do you know those 66 books of the Bible? Tell people about B66. Amen. Instead of focusing on things that really you don't fully understand, nor you have real control over. Let's pray. Let's trust God. And let's stand upon his word. Let's put our confidence in him. Let's rest in him, knowing that he is our deliverer. He is our strong tower. You want to talk about a 5G tower? You know, I don't want to talk about a 5G tower. I want to talk about the name of the Lord is a strong tower. And the righteous run into this tower and they are saved. They are healed. They are secure. We are in the world, but we are not of the world. God bless you, and remember, Jesus is Lord.